Hello friends, my name is Arun Kishore Voleti and welcome to my channel Learn Deep. We are currently in Python playlist. So as a part of a series of videos on pattern, this is my first video in which I am going to explain type 1 of basic patterns. So without wasting any time, I'll show you what exactly I mean by type 1 patterns. So the type 1 patterns is a box type pattern. A box type in the sense, each row will have same number of columns. So there are two categories in this box type patterns also. That is, there will be only one input given. Like if you see here, I have input as 4, so that I'll have 4 rows and each row will have 4 columns. But then there may be another category, like he is going to give number of rows as well as number of columns. Based on that, you need to take number of rows, and the number of columns will correspond to each row. Like if the number of columns is 3, then each row will have 3 number of columns. So without wasting any time, let us try to implement a program based on the 3 general steps which we have discussed in our previous video. If you don't watch my previous video, I am recommending you to watch the video first and followed by this video. So I'll rename this file as type 1. So as I said in my previous video, what are we supposed to do? We need to find how many number of rows we have. So here, okay, let's do one thing. I'll take input dynamically. I'll not consider 4 as my input. So what I'll do is I'll take my input n as dynamic value. N is equal to int of input of. So based on n, I am going to have my number of rows as well as my number of columns. So first of all, what are we supposed to do? We need to write a for loop for rows. So for row in range of n. And don't get confused with my naming convention. If you want, you can also take I instead of row, because it's just a variable. As you are in beginning, I recommend you to take I and J, but then when you got acquainted with patterns, try to write variable names according to the requirement so that your code will become more readable. So for better understanding, I'll also use I, J, K and some alphabets for naming the variables. Now what we have done is we have written a for loop for rows. Now what are we supposed to do? We need to find how many number of columns are there per row. So here in first row we have 4 columns, in second row also we have 4 columns, similarly in all rows we have 4 columns. And 4 is what? Our given input. If our input is 5, then we are going to have 5 columns. So again for columns also, for j in range of n we have to take. So what we have done, we have taken a for loop for number of rows as well as a for loop for number of columns, and we have taken columns for loop as a nested for loop for rows. Now what is our third step? We need to think what we have to print. Here we have to print star. So print star comma k. What happens if you just do this one? Let's check. Let's run this program. And what if our input is 4? So what are we going to get? We are going to get all stars 1 in each row. The reason is, in print statement or in print function, end is by default assigned with slash n. Now what are we supposed to do? We need to change the end value to a space or to a tab, whichever it may be. So by doing this, we got simplified with one step. So if I give my input here, like if my input is 4, then we are going to get everything horizontally. Now again, the reason is, I am going to append this end as an empty space for each print statement. But then after printing 4 stars, this pattern has to enter into a new line. So after printing each column, we need to enter a new line. So after printing a column means after writing a column for loop, we need to enter a new line. So we need to take one more print statement, which doesn't print anything. So there is no need to print anything. And if we run this, then you can observe. Okay. My input is 4. I'm going to get the pattern which I require. So this is our first example. And let's see what is our second example. Here we need to print 1 in first row, 2 in second row, 3 in third row, 4 in fourth row. So what are we supposed to print here? We are supposed to print numbers. We are supposed to print numbers here. So our second question, how to print these numbers? In first row we have 1, in second row we have 1, in second row we have 2, in third row we have 3, and in fourth row we have 4. Which means in each row we are going to print row number. So instead of printing star, what we can do? We can simply print the row number. So print of, here the row number will be stored in the variable I, comma and is equal to space. So if we do this, our output will be something like this. Okay, the reason why we got 0 and 3 is for loop will start from 0 and it will be considered till n. So if you write 0 n, if you write only n, the default value of the start will be 0. So we need to specify, we need to take 1 comma 1 plus n for each loop. So if you run this, we will get 1, 2, 3 and 4. So in our next example, we have to print 1, 2, 3 and 4 in each row. So in each row, what are we printing? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Can you guess what these numbers represent? Yes, these numbers represent column number. So in each time, what are we printing? We are printing column number. So taking instead of I, we can simply take J. And if I print, I am going to get 1, 2, 3 and 4 in each row. Now let's come to another part where we have a series of numbers. Like I need to print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and so on. So undoubtedly, they are not row numbers, as well as they are not column numbers, and they are not the sum of row number and column number also. So here, what are we supposed to do? The basic idea would be, we need to print 1 and we need to increment the value and we have to print 2. We need to increment this value and we have to print 3. And we need to increment this value and we have to print 4. So on, we'll continue till the end of pattern. So as we are discussing about incrementing, we need one more variable. I'll take variable as key and I'll assign it to 1. And instead of printing I, J and so on, what I'll do is I'll print key and I'll increment key after every print statement. So if I run this, and if I give my input 4, I'm going to get the required pattern. And if you want to see clearly, what we can do is we can take and as tab. So if you take tab, you'll get a huge space between numbers and they'll appear clearly, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So this is how type 1 patterns work. As I said, there may be one more input for number of columns. So I'll assume the number of rows as m and the number of columns as n. So now there will be only small variation. The first for loop will be written only for rows and the second for loop will be written only for columns. So if I run this, and if my number of rows are 5 and my number of columns in each row are 6, then the pattern would be something like this. And by simply changing the print statement, we can also obtain all these remaining examples using two inputs, one for row and one for column. So this is type 1 patterns. All we have done is we have simply implemented two for loops, and by changing this print statement, we have obtained all different set of patterns. From type 2 pattern, I am only going to explain how to get this star. But of course, by just changing the print statement, take it as an assignment and try to print I can't say what try also because just we are changing print statement. So practice to print all these remaining patterns. So that's all for this video. I'll meet you in my next video.